This is how I go. I go whether there's rain or snow.
When I was doing investment banking, I thought that I had a, you know, that was my ultimate goal. I'd worked so hard to get a chance to work on Wall Street, and that was it. That's what I wanted to do. I'd never ever thought that I was going to work, as managing director of Protect USA to, you know, help free and keep the Western world safe. I train people and groups, Israeli Krav Maga here in Manhattan, and I also train individuals and groups in wellness and fitness and athleticism, bodybuilding and body sculpting kinds of things.
That's it, Steph. Two more.
I've been practicing Krav Maga for 5 years. I've had 5 different training trips to Israel. 2 of the trips to Israel have been over 180 hours of training. So a total of well more than 500 hours of training in Israel.
It's going to be a car wreck, so you just have to take one punch and that's it. Yeah. So you start the exhale before it starts to come. Yep. And squeeze in before it starts to come. And just absorb as hard as you can.
Well, I'd been invited to Israel to train with the oldest and longest running Israeli Krav Maga Association recognized by the State of Israel.
So welcome to Netanya, everybody, and let's get ready to go to the gym.
Work so my son gon' remember you. Rubbing on his statue in his lab that resembles you. And what it meant to woo. Us forming like a family, you just blew. You was the chess piece on the board that made us look true. Watching your pen swish, you love frying kingfish. You the pearl in the ocean, I'm up on the land piss. Now you moving more prestigious. Me hitting the street, I know it's real. Guess I slept with the black Jesus.
The very first time I came, I met Orr, back when he was 17-ish. And, you know, we hit it off and became good buddies and told him many times that I wanted to come and help me grow the business in New York.
I think we'll take Manhattan down.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. And some of the other people that were there asked me if I wanted to go do some shooting and tactics training. And I said yes, and so we drove to Jerusalem, and that's when I met Itai.
This is the distance when conflict is going to begin.
Okay.
You saw suspicious behavior, there was a knife, and that's when you're going to react.
Okay.
Go! Go, Kevin, go, 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 go! Down, 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 down! I'm helping you, bam, 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 that's it! Very good.
He's been a commander and a captain in the field for the most elite counter-terror and hostage rescue arm of the Israeli Defense Forces for decades. I got along great with him, and I knew pretty much immediately that I wanted to do business with Itai Gil.
So what I'm saying is, people sometimes invest the money in the wrong places.
Yeah.
I want this camera, I want that camera, I want this here motion sensor, face recognition. I say it's not gonna help.
So now that I've spoken and trained with these police officers and undercover detectives and whatnot in Manhattan and realized the training that they don't have.
What you did not have is $1 million team.
Yeah, no.
To intervent, to engage in battle.
Really?
To get the job done. If the blade will go inside your organs.
Yeah, you're dead.
Even if there's a doctor next to you when he applies pressure, I'm not sure you'll live.
You need to be able to throw a very, very hard strike and very hard block and wrap up the wrist as hard as you can. So it's an excellent real-world, reality-based training. Welcome to Israel. Some of the adaptations are against a gun and against a knife. And then, of course, the most important thing is the active shooter.
The notebooks will give us a great chance.
There's one more.
Slowing down. Slowing down the ammunition destroys the bag, but that's it. Rips the books, but it increases your chances of surviving the upper mass, most lethal areas to get shot.
From time to time, an active shooter comes into a public place or a place of work or a place of study and immediately starts to attack people with guns. And by taking a very active role, you can immediately change the psychology of the attacker from hunting and just mowing down people to all of a sudden how their thinking changes and they're no longer just executing people. And this is what we look to do immediately, to change their psychology and to get them to stop shooting. So I think the world is very, very complex, and some parts of the world are always at war. While this is going on, if you don't know how to handle yourself in these kinds of situations, you know, there's going to be tragedies. You know, I look at who my friends and my family are, and you know, I want my friends and my family to be safe. I believe in freedoms. You know, freedom to do business, freedom to practice whatever religion that you want to do, the freedom to love who you want to love, and I believe in those, and I'd support, you know, the defense of those freedoms. Yeah.